This video is sponsored by Lexar.
Hey, what's up, people? So the Galaxy S20 Ultra has officially been out for a year, and it's gone through quite a bit of changes. They've made quite a few improvements, and it's aged quite nicely. So let's talk about my 1 year experience with the Galaxy S20 Ultra. When the Galaxy S20 Ultra was first announced, a lot of people did not pick up this phone just because it was so expensive. And over the past year, it has taken a price drop. You can pick this up for around $1,000 brand new and $800 renewed or refurbished. However, with the S21 Ultra coming out right around the corner, this one might even take more of a price drop, so make sure you keep your eyes out for pricing. So when it comes to overall durability this past year, my S20 Ultra has held up well. Now, granted, I did have a case on it, I did have a screen protector on it, and I think that you should. I mean, this phone's really expensive, and I definitely recommend both of those because you want to protect your investment, and that's what a phone is an investment. I did drop it a couple times with the case on it. There's no marks, no scuffs, nothing like that. I do have a few micro scratches on the curve where the display curves over to the backside, and that's one reason why I hate curved displays. You always get these weird micro scratches here, and that's the reason why I love like the new iPhone that has a flat display. So hopefully moving forward, we'll start to see Samsung implement flat displays more and more, but here's hoping, I guess. It's cold, I can't think straight. So the Galaxy S20 Ultra is using the Snapdragon 865, and rumor has it that the Galaxy S21 and S21 Ultra will feature the Snapdragon 888. However, the Snapdragon 865 has aged really well. I mean, you could do anything that you could possibly want to do on your mobile phone without any performance issues. You can edit video, play games, you can do a lot of multitasking. Dex works like a boss with this phone. So when it comes to performance, I would say the S20 Ultra has aged extremely well and should be good for the next couple of years. To go along with that performance longevity, you do have 5G on board. And even though I don't live in like a big 5G area, I do pick up T-Mobile 5G and the speeds are quite good. So you're already prepared for the next generation when it comes to cellular technology on the S20 Ultra. So the next thing I want to talk about is the fingerprint scanner. When the S20 Ultra first came out, the fingerprint scanner worked pretty good. I mean, it had some issues, it was kind of slow, but after a round of updates, it's really responsive, it's really quick, and I can get into my phone a lot quicker than previously. So that's one thing I gotta give Samsung props for. Like, the in-display fingerprint scanner has gotten a lot better. So one thing Samsung has been really good at is software updates. This is running One UI 3 and Android 11. Overall, it's a lot of visual changes, so everything feels and looks a lot snappier. Things look a little bit better. We have quick access to widgets. We have a new volume control panel right here. We can also double tap to lock the phone, which is something that's been needed for a while. And we also have Samsung Free, which is actually pretty cool. So we have free TV, pretty much, Samsung TV Plus. You can watch different shows over here. And we have stations like MTV, we have sitcoms, then we have Read, so this is gonna be like your news feed. And then they even give you free games to play. So overall, Samsung Free, in my opinion, is better than what it was previously, which was Samsung, what was it called? So overall, when it comes to software improvements and just adding features, Samsung has done a great job and the phone has matured beautifully. Now, to go along with software, we have a lot of new camera fixes and improvements as well as new features, and that's what we're gonna talk about next. The Galaxy S20 Ultra does have a micro SD card slot, and this is gonna come in handy because it shoots 8K video, and that can take up a lot of your internal storage. Luckily, you can pick up external storage from this video's sponsor, Lexar, for cheap.
Lexar recently released a new micro SD card, their 1066X. It's designed with Android smartphones in mind thanks to the A2 rating. This means the 1066X is fast and reliable enough to run and store apps straight from the S20 Ultra. Not only that, but it's one of the most universal micro SD cards on the market. It can seamlessly switch between action cameras, drones, and smartphones due to its excellent durability and consistent speeds. It's capable of up to 160 megabytes per second for the read and 120 megabytes per second for the write. The 1066X starts at $1,999 for a 64 gigabyte card and goes all the way up to 512 gigs. Check out the link in the description for more info or to pick up one for yourself.
So when the Galaxy S20 Ultra was first announced, one of the most hyped up features of this phone was the camera, but unfortunately it ended up being the biggest problem of this phone. However, Samsung pushed quite a few updates. They made the autofocusing better. The processing has gotten better. It has better highlight roll off. And overall, the camera is a night and day improvement from when it was first announced. And they also added several new features, which I'm gonna show you right now. One of the new improvements is something that I really appreciate, and that's the ability to lock your autofocus and your exposure much easier than before. So now when you tap the screen and then tap the lock, you can lock your focus and your exposure. However, if you're in pro mode and you tap the screen and then tap the lock, you can hold your finger down on the circle and you can drag your auto exposure separate from your autofocus. So you could have your focus down here and your exposure up here or your exposure over here. So it just gives you a little bit more flexibility. And the same thing can be said when you're in pro video mode. And while we're in pro video mode, another new feature that I really like is if you go and tap on 16:9, you now have manual mode for 8K, which if I'm not mistaken, was not available when the S20 Ultra was first, you know, announced. Outside of some visual enhancements, we also have improvements to the stabilization system. So if I go into the 100X telephoto, it's actually a little bit more stable. The image itself isn't really any more usable, but they did improve moon photos. So if you put your phone on like a tripod and then take a picture of the moon, it's gonna come out a little bit sharper than before. And the actual overall stabilization is more locked down as well. So overall, the S21 Ultra camera has improved tremendously. Does it still have issues? Yes. I mean, it's not the best focusing in the world, but it's a lot better than what it was initially. The processing has also improved. We have better color rendering, better highlight roll-off, better low light photography and video, and we still have one of the best wide angle cameras on a mobile phone. Plus, this is the last Samsung phone to feature a time of flight camera. So we're able to create 3D scans using this camera and then render them out all on this phone. To wrap this up, let's go ahead and talk about battery life. Now this phone features a 5,000 milliamp hour battery, and it's some of the best battery life on any Samsung phone. It's an all-day phone for sure. And if you're a power user, you have nothing to worry about. If you're not a power user, you're just a regular smartphone user, this can go a day and some. We have really fast charging, especially if you combine it with that 45 watt brick. It's like 0 to 50 in less than like 20 minutes. Like that's not true. I don't even know if that's true. But it's really fast charging. Like it's gonna give you some really fast charging speeds, and it has reverse wireless charging combined with fast wireless charging. So when it comes to the battery as a whole, it's fantastic. The Galaxy S20 Ultra is a fantastic phone even in 2021, even with the S21 coming out, because as that phone gets released, this phone's price is probably going to get cheaper. So I would not rule it out. Keep your eyes peeled. This is a great buy, especially if that price can get under 1,000 bucks. If you have any questions about the Galaxy S20 Ultra, leave them down below in the comment section. Make sure to check out all of my past videos on this phone. There's a lot of tips and tricks, comparisons, and my full review. Definitely check those out. If you guys enjoyed this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. Subscribe for more content like this, and I will see you beautiful people in the next video. I'm out. And it uses a time of flight autofocus. Focus. And to be honest, like, Bye. Are you recording?